Well, hello everyone. I hope you're having a blessed and beautiful day today. So today I wanted to read with you two different verses, one in Matthew and also one in Luke. And it's going to be talking a little bit about Barabbas. And I bring this person up today because I was thinking earlier, I was praying and I was meditating on the events of Easter, as I usually do this time of year. And something struck me as I was thinking about Barabbas, and I'll share with you what I what came to mind after we read these verses. So we're going to start off in Matthew 27:15, and it says, "Now it was the governor's custom at the feast to release a prisoner chosen by the crowd. At that time they had a notorious prisoner called Barabbas. So when the crowd had gathered, Pilate asked them, 'Which one do you want me to release to you, Barabbas or Jesus, who is called the Christ?' For he knew it was out of envy that they had handed Jesus over to him. While Pilate was sitting on the judge's seat, his wife sent him this message, 'Don't have anything to do with that innocent man, for I have suffered a great deal today in a dream because of him.' But the chief priest and the elders persuaded the crowd to ask for Barabbas and have Jesus executed. 'Which of the two do you want me to release to you?' asked the governor. 'Barabbas,' they answered. 'What shall I do then to Jesus, who is called Christ?' Pilate asked. They all answered, 'Crucify him.' 'Why? What crime has he committed?' asked Pilate. But they shouted all the louder, 'Crucify him.' When Pilate saw that he was getting nowhere, but that instead an uproar was starting, he took water and washed his hands in front of the crowd. 'I am innocent of this man's blood,' he said. 'It is your responsibility.' All the people answered, 'Let this blood be on us and our children.' Then he released Barabbas to them, but he had Jesus flogged and handed over to be crucified." Then we're going to move over to Luke. Let's see here. I'm sorry, let me find my... Okay, we'll go Luke 23, starting in verse 13. Pilate called together the chief priests and rulers and the people, and said to them, 'You brought me this man as one who was inciting the people to rebellion. I have examined him in your presence and have found no basis for your charges against him. Neither has Herod, for he sent him back to us, as you can see. He has done nothing to deserve death. Therefore I will punish him, then release him.' With one voice they cried out, 'Away with this man! Release Barabbas to us.' Barabbas had been thrown into prison for insurrection in the city and for murder. Wanting to release Jesus, Pilate appealed to them again, but they kept shouting, 'Crucify him! Crucify him!' For the third time he spoke to them, 'Why? What crime has this man committed? I have found in him no grounds for the death penalty. Therefore I will have him punished and then release him.' But the loud shouts they insistently demanded that he be crucified, and their shouts prevailed. So Pilate decided to grant their demand. He released the man who had been thrown into prison for insurrection and murder, the one they asked for, and surrendered Jesus to their will." So I bring this up because if we take a deeper look at the people that were shouting for Barabbas to be released, if we look at Barabbas and then we look at Jesus, we can see how much it mirrors of the people in today. If we look at Jesus and Barabbas standing side by side, we see Jesus, the most graceful, gracious, patient, loving Father, standing on one side. And then we see Barabbas, who is like a model of Satan, good and evil, standing together side by side. The people refuse and reject the one that they had seen all this time. They had seen the good that he had done. They had seen all the miracles and heard the good word that he had spoken, all the gospel. They had heard and seen him raise people from the dead and just love on people. And they were so hard-hearted that they rejected that and they went towards Satan. Barabbas. They wanted to free Barabbas instead of somebody who would save their souls. And we can see that today, how a lot of people reject Christ. We see a lot of people today that don't want to have anything to do with Christ. They choose their flesh. They choose the things of the world. They choose Barabbas instead of Jesus. And we know that Satan, he's a murderer, and he steals and destroys God's creation. And Barabbas was also a murderer. And after the rapture happens and during the millennium, people are still, Jesus is going to be sitting on the throne, and he is still going to be as merciful, and he's still going to be as loving, and he's still going to give as much grace as he did before. And people are still going to shout for Barabbas, Satan. They're still going to desire the will of Satan and the desires of their heart instead of the desire of Christ. And they are going to be right in front of him. They're going to see this King of Glory sitting on his throne, and they still choose to deny him, and even go so far as to say that they want him murdered again. And, you know, we see it's going to be, again, like I say, you know, it's going to be like history repeating itself, where people just, they're so wicked in their hearts that they would rather choose Satan over somebody as loving and precious as our Father. And, you know, we can see it even today. You know, Satan, he just hates God's creation. He hates everything that God has done. All of the good that comes from Christ, he hates it. So he's going to do whatever he can to destroy it. And the people in that time and in that day when Jesus was standing there, they couldn't even look at that man with the man of love that loved them and what he was going to do at that very moment for them, even though they hated him and even though they gave him over to be crucified. He loved them and he still died for them, even so. And, you know, they still couldn't see past their hard hearts and past their greed. They hated Jesus that much that they chose Barabbas over him. And so, you know, if we take a deeper look, like I said, you know, we take a deeper look, we can see the power of the good and evil and the battle between the flesh and the spirit going on between us. And, you know, a lot of people, they would rather choose or make an excuse for their behavior as saying that they can't help themselves, or, you know, they can't stop living in sin because they just can't do it. And in all actuality, you know, they're not trusting in Jesus Christ, and they're not giving and surrendering their life to him and allowing him to take all from you and take the sin from you. And, you know, yes, we will still continue to sin, but I mean, like, a living in sin, just continually living in that sin. And so as we come up to Easter, you know, we're going to be looking through the death and resurrection of Christ. We're going to celebrate his resurrection because he is alive and the grave is empty. And we are going to celebrate his soon return. And so I wanted to just share with you what I came across today and what touched my heart. And, you know, you can even think to yourself, you know, are you voting and chanting for Barabbas to be released, or are you chanting for Jesus Christ to be free in your life? And, you know, Satan is going to be bound for 1,000 years in hell, and people are still going to call and cry out for him to be released. And that just, it's such a burden, and it's so sad to even think about that people would actually do that, and they're going to be face to face with our King of Kings. I don't understand how people could do that, but they will. So, and how they could even, you know, muster up an idea to try to kill him a second time, it just drives me crazy. I don't understand how they could think that, but people are wicked. So so anyways, that's what I wanted to share with you today. And I hope you have a blessed and beautiful rest of your day, and I will try to come back tomorrow for Good Friday. And I know that some people are already in Good Friday, but we're going to do it tomorrow and then on Easter too. So with that, guys, I love you, and I will talk to you soon.